Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 150 to 175. These questions are generally belong to a burden of proof and onus provandi and res ipsa litteram. And there are some exceptions of burden of proof belong to these questions. These are questions are very important, so please pay attention on these questions whenever I read this question and mark this question, and focus on those points which I try to and which I underline these words. So these keywords are very important, and if you learn these keywords, they help in examination whenever you find out these objective questions, and you can easily guess out which is the correct answer of this question. Now starting here, question number 51. Which of the following is true as the standard of proof in criminal and civil proceeding? So in this question, the question asked which statement is true on the basis of the standard of proof in criminal proceeding or civil proceeding. Option A, the criminal proceeding, the standard is beyond the reasonable doubt. Yes, it is here, it is correct statement. It also in civil proceeding, yes, it is not correct statement. In civil proceeding, there is no provision of the beyond the reasonable doubt. In option B, criminal proceeding, its stand is beyond the reasonable doubt, while the civil proceeding is upon the balance of probability. Yes, this is correct answer here. The in criminal proceeding, it is beyond the reasonable doubt, burden of proof, yeah. But in civil proceeding, it is balance upon the probability. So standard of proof in criminal proceeding, beyond the reasonable doubt. In civil proceeding, balance of probability. So option B is correct here. Question number 151. Question number 152. The section 105 of Evidence Act apply to criminal trial, civil trial, both A and B, neither A nor B. In section 105 of Evidence Act, apply here in criminal trial. The section 105 provided the burden of proof that the case of accused within the exception, general exception. So general exception we are found in 76 to 106 of Evidence Act. Oh sorry, 106 of Indian Penal Code, general exceptions. So if the accused case is within these sections, so the burden of proof on that accused. So here answer is option A, criminal trial. Question number 153. The criminal trial, the onus is on the accused prove that his case is fallen. General exception, special exception, proviso to any provision, all of the above. So here answer is option all of the above. The criminal trial, the onus on the accused prove that his case fall in general exception, special exception, proviso to any provision. If the onus of proof on the accused and to prove that his case is fall in general exception, his case is fall in special exception, and any special proviso of a particular section, he should prove that his case is found belong to that proviso. So option D is correct here. Question number 154. In criminal trial, it is bound to presume that the case is accused fall in any of a general or special exception, that the case of accused fall in proviso to a provision under which he is charged. The absence of the case of the accused falling in any general special exception and the proviso to the provision under which the accused is charged. So option C is correct here. Question number 155. The criminal trial, the accused has to establish his plea, mitigation and justification of an offense beyond the reasonable doubt, prima facie, substantially, or either A or C. So here answer is prima facie. क्वेश्चन नंबर 106 ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 156 सेक्शन 106 ऑफ एविडेंस एक्ट एप्लीकेबल टू सच अ मैटर ऑफ डिफेंस विच आर सपोज टू बी स्पेशली विद इन द नॉलेज ऑफ डिफेंडेंट इन सच मैटर विच आर कैपेबल ऑफ बीइंग नोन टू द पर्सन अदर देन द डिफेंडेंट बोथ ए एंड बी नाइदर ए नॉर बी सो हियर आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए इज करेक्ट सच मैटर ऑफ डिफेंस विच आर सपोज टू बी स्पेशली विद इन द नॉलेज ऑफ द डिफेंडेंट सेक्शन 106 प्रोवाइडेड दैट द बर्डन ऑफ प्रूविंग द फैक्ट स्पेशली विद इन द नॉलेज ऑफ द पर्सन देर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इलस्ट्रेशन ए इज चार्ज फॉर विद द ट्रेवलिंग ऑन अ रेलवे स्टेशन रेलवे एंड विदाउट अ टिकट द बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ दैट ही हैड अ टिकट ऑन हिम यानी द बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ टू प्रूव दैट बिफोर द टिकट मास्टर ऑन द नॉट इन टिकट मास्टर द बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ ऑन द ए ही हैज द टिकट ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर 157 Any person in section 106 of Evidence Act refer a party to suit stranger to the state, the person who is not a party to the suit but is interested in the outcome of a suit, a witness, all of the above. So here answer is option A, party to the suit. Question number 158. The presumption continuance of life is contained in Section 107, 106, 106, 107, 108, 109. So here answer is option B, 107. Presumption of continuance of life is under section 107. So 107 presume that the person is lived for within 30 years. So here option here 30 year is very important here. If any person is a So, seen within the 30 year, the court presumes that he is alive. Question number 59, section 108 of Evidence Act relate to presumption of death, presumption of life, presumption of legitimacy, presumption of relationship. It is clear here. Option A is correct here. Presumption of death. Section 108 of Evidence Act refer that the presumption to be dead. If the person is not found or not hearing for the 7 years, the court presumes that he is died. Question number 160. For the presumption under section 107 of Evidence Act, the person is to be shown to be alive for within 7 year, within 12 year, within 3 year, within 30 year. So look at this question. The person asked the person is alive. Here important keyword is alive and section 107. So 107 is focused on the person who is alive and in duration is there 30 year. So here answer is option D, 30 year. In one question number section 108 provide the person is dead. So if the person is dead, their time duration is 7 years. Section 108 provide the presumption of death, their time is 7 years, and section 107 provide the presumption of life for time is 30 years. Question number 161. The presumption of death under section 108 of Evidence Act, the person is shown to be not heard for period. So here very important word here, presumption of death again here. So option B is correct here, 7 years. Question number 162. The presumption under section 109 of Evidence Act as to certain human relationship, option A, is obligatory and arises the irrespective of the lapse of time, is a permissive permissive or end operate it's only for a period for which the state of things which are the subject matter of the presumption ordinarily last is a obligatory and operate only for the period for which the state of things which are subject matter of presumption ordinarily last. Option D, either B or C. So here answer is option A is correct here. Is obligatory and arises irrespective of the lapse of time. So section 9 provided that the burden of proof relationship in cases of, there are very important keyword here, partner first point here. Second option, second important keyword is landlord, and third tenant, and fourth principal, and last one is agent. So the partner, landlord, tenant, principal, agent. The burden of proof as to relationship in case of partners, landlord, and tenant and principal agent is obligatory and arises irrespective of a lapse of time. Question number 163. The principle that the possession is prima facie, the proof of ownership is contained in. So it is contained in, clear here, section 110 of Evidence Act. The section 110 provides the burden of proof as to ownership. So here important word is ownership, proof of ownership. Question number 164. The possession contemplated under section 110 of Evidence Act, judicial possession, symbolic possession, actual physical possession, all of the above. So here answer is actual physical possession. Question number 165. Section 110 of Evidence Act, in its operation, is limited to immovable property, is not limited to immovable property, and appear to movable property as well, is not limited to immovable property but apply only to certain movable property. So section 10 of Evidence Act, its operation is apply is not limited immovable property and apply to movable property as well, means section 110 is apply the immovable property as well as movable property. Question number 166. Section 112 of Evidence Act provide very important section. But 112 of Evidence Act provide for presumption of life, presumption of marriage, presumption of death, presumption of legitimacy. This is very important word here, legitimacy. So section 110 provide the legitimacy of child. Option D is correct here. Question number 167. Section 112 of Evidence Act contain the presumption of fact, rebuttable presumption of law, irrebuttable presumption of law, a mixed presumption of fact and law. So it is very clear here, it is irrebuttable, no evidence is required to prove it and not contradict this presumption of legitimacy of child, paternity of child is irrebuttable presumption of law. Question number 168. The presumption under section 112 of Evidence Act is arised when child born during the continuance of valid marriage, when the child born within the 280 days of dissolution of marriage, the mother remaining unmarried in both A and B, in only A, not B. So here answer is both A and B. The child born during the valid marriage, continuance of the valid marriage, and option B, the child born within 280 days of dissolution of marriage, the mother remain unmarried. In such condition, the father of the child is the person who is the marriage or that mother divorced from that person during this period 280 days. क्वेश्चन नंबर 169, इन केस अ चाइल्ड बॉर्न 280 डेज ऑफ डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ मैरिज द मदर रिमेनिंग अनमैरिड द प्रिजम्पशन ऑफ लेजिटिमेसी ऑफ चाइल्ड अंडर सेक्शन 212 ऑफ एविडेंस एक्ट अराइजेज इफ द फादर इज अलाइव ऑन द डे द चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न इफ द फादर इज नॉट अलाइव ऑन द डे द चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न इररिस्पेक्टिव वेदर फादर इज अलाइव और डेड ऑन द डे द चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न आइदर ए और बी सो हियर आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी इज करेक्ट इररिस्पेक्टिव देयर इज नो मैटर आइदर फादर इज अलाइव और डेड एट द टाइम ऑफ व्हेन द चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न क्वेश्चन नंबर 170 सेक्शन 112 ऑफ एविडेंस एक्ट अप्लाई व्हेन देयर इज अ डिस्प्यूट रिगार्डिंग द मैटरनिटी ऑफ चाइल्ड पैटरनिटी ऑफ चाइल्ड बोथ ए एंड बी एंड आइदर ए और बी सो आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्रेस द सेक्शन 112 इज एक्सप्रेस द पैटरनिटी ऑफ चाइल्ड सो ऑप्शन बी इज करेक्ट हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 171 द डिसाइडिंग द फैक्टर अंडर सेक्शन 112 ऑफ एविडेंस एक्ट इज द डेट ऑफ बर्थ ऑफ चाइल्ड द डेट ऑफ कंसेप्शन ऑफ चाइल्ड द डेट ऑफ बर्थ और द डेट ऑफ कंसेप्शन डिपेंडिंग ऑन द फैक्ट एंड सर्कमस्टेंस ओनली बी नॉट ए सो हियर आंसर इज डेट ऑफ बर्थ ऑफ चाइल्ड सेक्शन 140 ऑफ एविडेंस एक्ट प्रोवाइड फॉर सर्टेन प्रेजम्पशन ऑफ फैक्ट प्रेजम्पशन ऑफ फैक्ट रिबुटेबल प्रेजम्पशन ऑफ लॉ इररिबुटेबल प्रेजम्पशन ऑफ लॉ प्रेजम्पशन ऑफ फैक्ट एंड लॉ बोथ सो सेक्शन 70 क्वेश्चन नंबर 172 सेक्शन 114 प्रोवाइड द प्रेजम्पशन ऑफ फैक्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 114 प्रोवाइड दैट द कोर्ट मे प्रिज्यूम सो हियर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड कोर्ट may presume this may is very important here so may shows that the presumption of fact is there presume the existence of certain fact the court may presume there is no shall use here so it is clear here the presumption of fact is there question number 173 an accomplice is not a competent witness against an accused A competent witness against an accused, not a competent witness against an accused, either A or C, cannot competent or not competent. So here answer is option B is correct. Accomplice is a competent witness against the accused. The provision of accomplice provided in section 133 of Evidence Act provide the provision of accomplice. Presumption is evidence is a proof shown on whom the burden of proof is lie all of the above. So here answer is option C shown on whom the burden of proof lie. Question number 175. This is the final question of this video. The presumption as to abatement of suicide by a married woman has been provided. Option A, 111A of Evidence Act, 113A of Evidence Act, 113B of Evidence Act, 113 of Evidence Act. So here answer is 113A of A of Evidence Act. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video and click on like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel and we will continue this video series in next part 8 and in that part we cover question number 175 to 200. Thank you for watching. Thank you.